Welcome back to the channel. So I just put on some makeup to make myself look older, and I think that I've outgrown pink. It doesn't look good. Actually looks better on camera than it does in real life, but I don't know how Jenim creates such cohesive looks. Like, I'm struggling so hard to make my black eyeliner go along with my pink blush. Anyways, so today we're going to talk about some differences I found between American versus Vietnamese culture. And these are differences I've noticed in the past year. So as a result, I haven't included these in any previous videos. So the first difference between American and Vietnamese culture is how we view pets. In America, people love pets. They treat them as one of their own. However, in Vietnam, pets are just animals that coexist with you. Like, you don't go out and get a cat or a dog. The cat or dog comes to you and you feel bad for it, so you start feeding it outside and then it becomes your pet. In America, it's a whole industry where people breed cats and dogs and other animals specifically to be raised as pets. So the idea of me owning any other animal besides a fish growing up didn't exist. Like, my parents will leave food out for stray cats, but that's about it. So I told my mom I was thinking about getting a cat, and she was like, why would you want to do that when you can't even take care of yourself? And she was saying how cats' fur will give you allergies and all this other stuff. In America, swimming is a social activity you need to know how to do in order to fit in. In Vietnam, there's no swimming pools. There's no need to ever learn how to swim. Even the boat people who left Vietnam didn't know how to swim. Well, that's because, like, they didn't know they were gonna be boat people. But, like, there's no need to learn how to swim. As a result, I never learned how to swim. I had to teach myself how to swim by signing up for a class during my senior year of college. And even then, I still can't swim. Because I learn in a very controlled environment. And whenever I get into a community pool, there's just too many people. And this community pool was filled with little kids who knew how to swim. It was like a natural instinct for them. American culture values the individual. Vietnamese culture values the community or group. For example, my mom was telling me to go wash my sister's dishes. I was like, why should I wash them? They're her dishes. It's not my responsibility. And another example, my mom is worrying about how we're gonna move out all my sister's stuff. I'm like, why are we worrying about this? This is her stuff. Shouldn't she find a way to get all this stuff home and get it into storage? Like, it's not my problem, it's her problem. But my mom views my sister's problems as the whole family's problems, and we have to come together in order to help her with her problems. American and Vietnamese people also view careers differently. So you've already know or heard the stereotype that Vietnamese people or Asian people only want their children to be doctors, lawyers, accountants, etc., etc. So basically, practical jobs. While my parents never wanted me to be a doctor or a lawyer, they always pushed me to study CS or computer science because the demand for computer science is very high right now. See, practicality. Whereas the demand for actors, writers, screenwriters, producers, directors is very low. As a result, I keep telling my mom and dad, I want to move to California. And I want to act, I want to direct, I want to make movies. And they keep saying, stop dreaming. So there you have it. Some differences between American and Vietnamese culture that I recently discovered. Leave in the comments below what differences you see between the two cultures. And if you like this video, please subscribe for more. See you in the next one.